The title of my talk is Effect of Histone Deacetylase Inhibitor on the Hepatic Differentiation of Mesenchymal Stem Cells in 3D Scaffold. Stem cells are a special type of cells that have ability to differentiate into multiple lineages like bone cells, fat cells, cardiac cells. There are two broad categories of stem cells, embryonic stem cells and adult stem cells. Adult stem cells are further divided into bone marrow stromal cells, hematopoietic stem cells, and resident tissue stem cells. Stem cells can be differentiated into multiple lineages by using chemical, biological, and physical methods. Liver is an important organ of the body that performs several important functions, including detoxification of waste, storage of protein, vitamin, glycogen, metabolism, and also liver provides immunity. Liver is the only visceral organ that possesses the capacity to regenerate. Liver regeneration is the process by which the liver is able to replace lost liver tissue from the remaining tissue, but it has a capacity to regenerate about 25% only. Number of diseases like liver cancer, cirrhosis, hepatitis, liver failure, and non-fatty acid liver diseases limit liver regenerative potential. Currently, liver diseases are treated with drugs, but drugs affect the normal functioning of the liver due to higher level of drug-induced toxicity. Liver transplantation is an ideal treatment of option for end-stage liver diseases. However, due to higher cost, surgical complication, use of immunosuppressive drugs, and shortage of donor limits its use. Stem cell-based therapy could contribute to overcome the burden of liver diseases. Stem cells can be differentiated using epigenetic modifier. Histone modification is one of the key epigenetic regulation that play important role in stem cell differentiation. So the rationale of this study is liver diseases are a common cause of death all over the world. Liver transplant is an ideal treatment option for end-stage liver diseases, but this procedure is limited due to many factors. Stem cells have ability to differentiate into various lineages, including hepatocyte, thus consider attractive source for hepatic cell therapy. Epigenetic modifications improve stem cell differentiation efficiency and cell reprogramming. However, 2D culture can't assimilate the required microenvironment and cell signaling that observed in vivo. So in vivo hepatic microenvironment provides ideal conditions for development and maturation of stem cells derived hepatocytes. So the goal of this study was to characterize the mesenchymal stem cells isolated from red bone marrow to observe the cytotoxic effect of histone deacetylase inhibitor on the mesenchymal stem cells and to analyze the differentiation potential of HDACI-treated mesenchymal stem cells in 2D and 3D microenvironment. So the isolation and propagation of mesenchymal stem cells were done in cell culture. Then MSCs were characterized on the basis of the different surface marker via immunostaining, and then their adipocyte and osteocyte differentiation assays were performed. Finally, MSCs were treated with optimized dose of HDACI in 2D and 3D culture. And then hepatic differentiation was analyzed using immunostaining and qPCR. So mesenchymal stem cells in 2D culture showed fibroblast-like morphology in passage 0 and passage 1. Cells distribution is an important phenomenon in cell differentiation. So here, 3D collagen scaffold showed homogeneous mesenchymal stem cells distribution in 3D collagen scaffold after 21 days of treatment. After successful isolation and propagation of mesenchymal stem cells, characterization of MSCs were done by using MSC-specific markers that includes CD90, CD29, and CD117, that is c-KIT, and we got the positive expression of MSC-specific marker. The next step was to check the adipogenesis and osteogenesis in MSCs. MSCs in adipogenic medium showed intracellular lipid droplet, while in osteogenic medium, MSCs showed calcium deposit. So after the successful characterization of MSCs, we move to the next step. That was the treatment of mesenchymal stem cells with the optimized dose of HDSCI. So first we check the cytotoxic effect of this HDSCI on MSCs. And for that we use different concentration of HDSCI from 2.5 to 20 millimolar. And here we can see that 20 millimolar concentration of VPA, that is the HDSCI, it causes the cell death. So we selected 5 millimolar VPA concentration for the treatment of MSCs for hepatic differentiation. So after treatment of MSCs with 5 millimolar VPA, we perform qPCR and we analyze the hepatic specific gene that is CK18, alpha fetoprotein and albumin in 2D and 3D culture. And we got the higher expression of all of the hepatic genes, that is CK18, AFP and ALP. However, the 3D culture showed more upregulation of the hepatic genes. In the next step, we analyze the hepatic proteins in 2D culture and 3D culture. And we use the alpha fetoprotein and albumin antibodies. And we got the higher expression of hepatic protein, AFP and ALB in 3D culture as compared to the 2D culture. While the CD90, that is the marker of the stem cells, there is no change in the expression of the CD90. So MSCs were successfully treated with the histone deacetylase inhibitor in 2D and 3D culture. HDSCI have considerable effect on the hepatic differentiation from red bone marrow derived MSCs. However, further research is needed to improve the maturation status of differentiated hepatocytes. Thank you.